Hello and welcome to this special update of Energy Independence Magazine. I'm your host, Dwight Cromie. Recently, while fighting a commercial building fire, an aerial ladder from one of the fire trucks came in contact with a 12,000 volt power line, injuring three of the firefighters. We talked with Battalion Chief Kevin Valentin about the incident and how the electrical safety awareness course provided by NECA and IBEW to firefighters, police, and first responders saved the lives of these and possibly more firefighters that night. Kevin, can you tell me, you took some courses offered by the IBEW and NECA regarding electrical safety. Can you tell me what that was about?
Yes, it was how to prevent firefighters from becoming injured on a fire incident, safety situational awarenesses we need to be looking out for. A very good course on electrical safety, primarily in the fire service, is the direction he was taking us, what we need to be concerned about. Excellent class, talked to us about how to move around electrical incidents, how to hop instead of walking, shuffle our feet, what to touch, what not to touch, things of that nature, you know, what to be on the lookout for at incidents that could cause bodily harm. So it was excellent class.
Now, you recently had an incident within your fire department where you responded to a call during the late or early morning. Can you tell me a little bit about that incident?
Yes, on the evening of May 24th at about 11:50 p.m., we responded to a 50-foot by 100-foot commercial building, which was well involved in fire. We set up a defensive attack, monitors off fire engines, as well as a ladder pipe operation. It took about 30 minutes to extinguish the fire, and while we were closing up everything, mopping up, bringing the ladder pipe down, the ladder came in contact with 12 kV wires. Three personnel were injured during that incident. The engineer or the operator that was up on the ladder sustained some mild shocking, while the two other personnel that were on the ground in contact with the truck itself sustained pretty severe injuries.
What helped protect those firefighters during that operation? I understand the things that you learned in the fire safety class actually maybe helped save those lives.
Absolutely. When we ran over to the injured firefighter, they were actively being what I call electrocuted, violently shaking. We walked up to them cautiously once they stopped shaking by shuffling our feet. We were able to coach the first firefighter out. He was on the ground on his back shaking. Just through persuasion and coaching him, he was able to crawl out of the zone and to safety. The second firefighter, he collapsed. He was unconscious, so we kind of shuffled our feet up to him, quickly swiped his boots to make sure he wasn't energized, grabbed him, and then kind of shuffled back. Once we got him to safety, we worked on the last firefighter who was up on the truck. And just through coaching, got him to jump off of the truck without stepping onto the ground. And once he was on the ground, we instructed him to either bunny hop or shuffle his feet out of a zone which could possibly have been energized.
And for those who don't know what we're talking about, this is something you learned at the fire safety class about what to do when in an energized zone. Can you kind of tell me what that is and how it was instructed to you?
Well, I don't remember the terminology. I just remember from the class, what played in my mind was CJ would tell us, you know, the ground could be energized, so if you step into that, you will become a victim too. Always shuffle your feet in. If you start to feel a little charge, then you know that you're in the zone. That was one method. The other method was using a bunny hop method, 2 feet in and then 2 feet out, and without making contact on separate feet, always 2 foot method. So had never known that before until CJ came out and presented that to us. Otherwise, we could have had many more victims on this incident.
So in your opinion, this fire safety course that you received in October truly saved not only the lives of those three firefighters, but possibly other firefighters, correct?
Absolutely. You know, we called a firefighter down. Every firefighter on the scene ran up to this incident. So had they not been trained properly, they could have all ran right up to it, got into a zone where they shouldn't have been, and they all injured.
During the incident, I understand some of the firefighters were shouting, "Remember what CJ said." Is that true?
That's true. As the guys were approaching, they were shouting, "Hey, remember CJ's rules, remember what he taught you," and that's how it helped, I think, reassure and calm the guys and to be able to instruct the individual off the truck by remembering those steps and methods that CJ had taught us.
As a battalion chief, would you recommend this course to other fire departments around the state of California?
Absolutely. If you have not had this course, you're missing out. I'm going to schedule it every year as a refresher to my guys, just to reinforce the importance of being situationally aware around electricity.
Historically, firefighters are trained to operate in all high-risk environments. But incidents involving potentially energized equipment has always been an area of concern. Firefighters have always been told to avoid contact and wait for the power company to arrive. The NECA IBEW Electrical Awareness Safety Course is helping fill those gaps that exist in their training, providing first responders with the knowledge of what to do or not to do when immediate intervention is necessary. We talked to CJ Hamilton, who is the NECA IBEW Electrical Safety Course instructor, about this incident and his course provided to firefighters and first responders. CJ, can you tell me, when you got the word that you may have helped save some firefighters in the Colton City Fire Department, what did it mean to you?
It was really kind of, no pun intended, shocking to me. I got this phone call, and it was Chief Benefield from the Colton Fire Department. He just let me know. He said, "Hey, you know, we sent a couple of firefighters to the hospital this weekend, and because of you and your course, we didn't send them to the morgue," which really kind of, it was just a feeling I've never had before. You know, I'm an electrician, you know, I'm not a firefighter. I don't save lives, they do. But when someone puts this on your shoulders that because of what you did and you gave them the knowledge that you had and showed them what, you know, what electricity might do, could do, should do, and won't do, they took that knowledge in an incident that was really bad and made it so they could save some lives. And I mean, after the phone call, honestly and truthfully, I went in and talked to my wife and we both had tears, you know, in our eyes because, you know, it was just a feeling that I've never had before.
CJ, what specifically about your course did these firefighters use that possibly saved their lives?
Well, in our class, we have three sections that we train on: arc flash, arc blast, down power lines, and the Faraday cage. In this incident, they used the down power lines. From what I understand and what I've heard through the different stories that's gone on, they got one of the firefighters off the truck by using the bunny hop, which is means you when you get off of a vehicle, you don't touch the ground and the vehicle at the same time. You hop off onto the ground, both feet at the same time, and don't touch the vehicle behind you once you exit the vehicle. And then you do what we call the old man shuffle, which is keep your feet on the ground and shuffle them, or the bunny hop, where you just take short hops to get out of that field. Because when electricity hits the ground, that voltage, 12,000, it can travel up 30 feet. And so what we want to do is get them out of that area. The other two that were hit by the electricity from the back of the truck, putting the hose in, they were stuck there. They waited for the auto reloader to hit. When the auto reloader shut off, that's a timing situation where it actually shuts off. You got 10 to 15 seconds before it reloads. They used that to get the other firefighters out of harm's way.
And do you think, or do you feel it's important that firefighters and fire departments around the country and in this state take your course or courses like it?
Absolutely. We have got stacks of letters from fire chiefs, firefighters, telling us how the course has absolutely helped them save lives, kept them out of trouble. And the thing is, we're not training something really crazy. All we're doing is training on what electricity might do, could do, should do, and won't do. See, the whole idea is if you've got the knowledge of what electricity will do, then it's going to help you. And that's all we're doing. We're giving them the knowledge of electricity, and then they take it from there, and it works out fine.
CJ, I just want to clarify that this course is offered by the National Electrical Contractors Association and the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, absolutely free to firefighters. Is that correct?
That is correct. It's absolutely free to firefighters, paramedics, and police officers.
In a letter from Don Benfield, the Colton Fire Department Battalion Chief, to the Electrical Awareness Safety Course instructor, CJ Hamilton, the Colton and Loma Linda Fire Departments wanted to thank him for the training that he provided, stating that it saved lives during this unfortunate incident. NECA and IBEW, along with the Labor Management Cooperation Committee, has to date provided nearly $1 million in electrical safety training to thousands of firefighters and first responders across the region, at no charge to them or the department, in an effort to protect those who protect our communities. I'm Dwight Cromie, and I want to thank you for watching this very special update of Energy Independence Magazine. We'll be right back.